Right, everybody, welcome. Well, actually, it's not really welcome back, but hello again. I was talking a little bit ago about how I don't get any views on these videos, but I'm having fun doing it, so. Well, in general, on my videos, but I'm having fun doing it, therefore, I'm gonna keep the video game commentary. Now,
let's do this.
What was I going to talk about? Oh, yes, what I want to talk about related to that, you know, as a video game commentator that nobody ever watches or listens to. It gives me kind of an interesting perspective, in my opinion. I've noticed that it's really freaking hard to get started. You know, getting views is really freaking hard to get started. Like, it's not impossible. I know there's probably people that have got, you know, that people that, you know, maybe got started instantly. Now, you know, I'm assuming there's probably other factors in mind. Like, you know, for instance, I'm probably not the most ludicrously funny person in the world to talk to, because I know I'm not the funniest person in the world to talk to. But hey, whatever. Yeah, I know there's like different factors. Running away. Anyways, yeah, I know there's different factors that bring it up, like, for instance, like, you know, like I said, funniness. If you're very funny, you're more likely to get views. If you're very good, you're likely to get views, because people like to watch those who are funny. Watch people who are good. That guy's not there anymore. Well, that guy's still there, but I'm not gonna be able to do anything about him.
Enemy UAV is in.
Like I said, you're very good. People might want to watch you just because people like to see people others succeed. People like to see each other, like to watch others succeed in video games. Not necessarily in general. Like, people also like to watch people fail. Damn it, he's good. Also, it didn't help that I was being stupid, but he's definitely better than me. Darn it. He's camping that spawn point like a motherfucker.
Enemy UAV is airborne.
Sup? That's not a good sign that there's UAV up. I really don't like that sign. Especially considering there's somebody over in this area. Oh good, he's possibly gone. I'm not sure if there's a camo or something here, a ghost equivalent. I don't remember. If there is, nobody's ever uses it because it's stupid. It's probably better to pick, like, one of the required perks, which would be Stopping Power or Juggernaut. One of the less than required but very helpful perks. Right, he's dead anyway, so it wouldn't matter if I pulled out my grenade and threw it up there. See, that thing's still there? Crap, alright, there's two more in here, I didn't know. Darn it. Anyways, this is stupid to go the way I'm going right now, by the way. Never do this on block. You're gonna get your head popped off pretty quickly. That guy's a really bad shot. Like, really bad. See, alright. Yeah, running across those is an easy way to die. Quickly. Without mercy. Nobody. You're going to die quickly by going those ways. You don't get a chance to know. Reasons why are simple. Number one, snipers can see you and you have to climb over those edges. Well, you know, keep running over those edges there, which if there's snipers on either side, they can blow your brains out. Damn it. Number two, you can't assess the situation in these locations here, like these little pockets here. Yeah, it's kind of just random luck. I'm not staying here. Yep, see, that's why. That guy's dead? I'm not. That's why I left. I knew they would die if I stood there. Yeah, running across, though, is really stupid. I probably shouldn't have done it earlier, because now those seven, now that level 7 there and a bunch of other dumbasses are going to be doing it on my team. Damn it, he knifed me. I should probably knife more. I don't. But anyways, yeah. Back to what I said. Yeah, comes here. Creating a bunch of videos and, you know, it gives me a kind of a unique situation, because I know my situation isn't perfect for this, for being a video game commentator. I'm not, extremely funny, I'm not, ludicrously amazing player. I'm not a whole bunch of other... I'm not like quirky or interesting, I'm just kind of just a regular, casual guy who plays games for fun. So I'm not like anything ludicrously special or interesting or unique or a female. Although that being said, female is not necessarily a positive thing when it comes to gaming. Yeah, sure, you can get into it a bit more. People usually click on a female, are more likely to click on and listen to a female individual's thing longer. You know, at first, or more, you know, early on, they can get, they can pick up a few extra people, but after that, I've noticed that people just kind of get bored of them. Legit sent me a message. It's a friend of mine. Let's see. Although with the most annoying gamer name ever. He's a great guy, though. He's an annoying kid. No, thank you. I don't want to play Minecraft. I have it, I just don't feel like playing it.
Enemy UAV is airborne.
But anyways, yeah. Crap. I could have run up and grabbed. Nah, that would have been stupid. Like I said, females get the, early, you know, being a female in general just kind of gets you a bit early, extras because people are like, oh, hey, it's a female subscriber. There's a female person doing video games, cool, and they, there's a lot of people who are looking for video games are males, that is a fact. Now that's not, you know, video game playthroughs, not, I'm not talking about video games, but a lot of people who do video game playthroughs are looking for, a lot of them are males and they're dumb as heck, because they're, well, not dumb as heck, they're just kids and they don't know what they're doing. They kind of are insanely run by their hormones, which is, you know, the way being a youth is. What was I saying? But yeah, but after that, though, the problem is with female subscribers is that, I mean, people, subscriptions that a lot of people, I mean, gaming commentators, a lot of people, like, expect them to be certain ways. They expect them to be... Sup? Nice gun. Thanks for the ammo. Anyways, they expect them to be a certain way. They expect them to do everything in a certain way, which is unfortunate, but it's the way it is. And they expect, and since they have these expectations about them, they can't really. It's hard to do exactly what you want, as their fans will end up leaving them. Yeah, their fans will end up leaving them. For whatever stupid reason that they desire. Webby, you son of a... Winvey is a good guy. He's definitely good. I don't know who he is, but he's good. I'll tell you that much. Just a heads up, you can put bombs into some of these roofs here, so don't be afraid to pull an airstrike on him. Yep. That's why you were. That's why he's a suppressor. Okay. Anyways, females can get the initial boost, but after that they have a problem retaining them because people expect them to be, do certain things certain ways and so on. If they don't follow that that perspective, then they start losing fans and so on and so forth. And it kind of limits them to what they want to do. It limits them on the potential. If they want to keep their fans, they gotta keep doing the things they want. If they don't. To keep their fans, they have to be the person they want to be. But also on top of that, to keep their fans, they have to act like the way their fans want. It's impossible to do both, unless the way your fans want is the way you are, which is very unlikely. I highly doubt that. And if you're not either one of those, if you're not both of those simultaneously, you'll lose some early on. Now, if you keep doing it continually, if you keep going on and on, people like who you are directly, then you can keep doing stuff. It's not hard. It's fun, but yeah, that's how it is. You kind of lose it. They have a perspective, a mindset. It's annoying, but it's true. All right. I'll start the next commentary now. Hold on a sec. I need to get more water.